Hey guys, welcome once again. From the early 21st century, electronic industry is contributing in every field. Apart from powering the system or providing the services, electronics is used extensively in medical equipments to help the doctors. Using specific analysis and computer programming, scientists can do biological studies. Biomedical electronics is one of those fields which is filling the gaps between engineering and medicines. The electronic implant is technology where we can put electronic devices inside the human body for betterment of body performance or treatment purposes. Since 1958, this technology is creating wide impact over the world, and there are numerous implantable devices available today. These implants are basically tiny capsule-sized devices which human can consume them orally or it can be injected inside the body. And some edible devices are designed to remain inside the body for some period of time. They will do their job there and get disposed out. Also, for lifestyle diseases like diabetes has led to an increased demand for implantable devices like continuous glucose monitoring, which measures the glucose level present inside the body, and implantable infusion pumps. They are used to deliver fluid like saline into patient's body in a controlled manner. When cochlea, a sensory organ of hearing, is malfunctioning due to absence or reduction in cochlear cells, then a device can be used which carries out the function of cochlea by stimulating auditory nerves directly. A Monash Vision Group is developing Genaris, a bionic vision system which restores the functional vision for people who acquired retinal diseases. Genaris has been designed to bypass damage to the eye and optic nerve to restore the functional vision to people who have lost their sight through traumatic injury and conditions such as glaucoma and acquired retinal disease. For edible electronics, a good interface between implanted devices and the brain can help at greater extent. For example, a small electrode called strain rod, which is developed by University of Melbourne, is implanted into blood vessels and joining the areas of the brain that controls the movements, which can return motor functioning into a person who is paralyzed due to stroke or spinal cord injury. This can be installed without opening the patient's skull. It is really a revolutionary technology. Neuralink, the company funded by Elon Musk, is working on implantable brain-computer interfaces. They are developing an injectable syringe having flexible substrate which is soft enough to sit harmlessly inside the brain and has electrical properties that enables the target part of the brain to receive the electrical stimulus. It is the future of implantable devices, and it will help people with degenerative brain diseases and neurological disorders. Another company from Israel named Given Imaging has invented a pill cam series which is composed of pills with ingestible cameras, which can help doctors to view different parts of the patient's digestive system. It is a painless alternative to tests like endoscopy or colonoscopy. This pill cam uses a camera to take high-speed photos as it goes down the intestinal tract. These images are transmitted to a recording device which is reviewed by doctor. This company also has developed a smart pill that measures pressure, pH and temperature as it travels to the intestinal tract. This helps doctor to assess gastrointestinal mobility. Just like devices, we can implant robots into the human body. A Switzerland-based research center presented a prototype of completely edible soft actuator. The actuator is basically a device which controls a mechanism or system. An actuator is primary stage of robot. The actuator can bend when inflated and straighten out when pressure is reduced. It is a biocompatible and environmentally sustainable. These robots could mix with nutrients or pharmaceutical components to improve healing, digestion and metabolism. However, there are some challenges to edible electronics, like it is impossible to implant or consume something which is very bulky, so the devices should be as tiny as possible. Other challenge is thermal management. The temperature of the device should not harm the surrounding tissues. The device should be biocompatible, which must not cause any adverse effect inside the body, and it must be stable in there. The material used to build these devices should not contain cancer-causing toxins and mostly be made of natural suited for human body. Well, scientists are working to limit these problems and improve this technology. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section. Hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to my channel. And finally, thanks for watching.